మా తీరిని వాస్తాయ పండరీపురవాసిని పాండురంగ ప్రకాశాయ విఠలాయ నమో నమః. మరుత్పుత్రాయ కవయే భీమాయ భయహరణే శ్రీమదానందతీర్థాయ ప్రఖ్యాతాయ నమో నమః. డియర్ చిల్డ్రన్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్, జయ శ్రీ కృష్ణ, నమస్తే. ద అదర్ డేస్ మెసేజ్ వాస్ థింక్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణ యాజ్ ఫాదర్ అండ్ మదర్. దిస్ డే ఐ రైట్ థింక్ ఆఫ్ కృష్ణ యాజ్ రిలేటివ్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్. త్వమేవ బంధుశ్చ సఖా త్వమేవ. వెన్ వీ కేమ్ ఇన్ టు దిస్ వరల్డ్ our relatives are born with us. We have no choice. They are the good or bad fruits of our karma. Some we like, some we don't. Some of them like us, some of them we are also fond of. Yet as we grow up through various vistas of life, we travel, our perspective changes. We realize whether they are true relatives in the sense our well-wishers. Are they with us for good or not? Or do they exploit us for what we have and our parents have? In course of time, their odd behavior hurts us, sometimes harms us. Sometimes if it is outrageous, our bonds snap and we are no more connected with our so-called relatives. If we think of the Lord as our relative, there are no frustrations of behavior on his side. He remains steady as ever, ready to listen to our appeal, willing to stand up by us, stand by us through thick and thin. His strength becomes the foundation of our life. We are no more afraid of life and its very curse, unpredictability. With the Lord by our side, we call him Father, Mother, Krishna, and so on. Our relatives have their whimsical moods and other priorities too. When the devotee is concerned, the Lord remains with us 24/7. Other relatives come to receive, he comes to give, and thus enhances our image in the eyes of the world. This act of owning him as relative is a privilege. He never lets us down as a true relative. His power being immense, his grace is also immense. To him, our life is a small playground where he teaches us the art of living. God is the one relative full of feeling who also grows in our growth. The next phrase in the message is, Tvameva Sakhacha. O Krishna, you are my own friend. Who is a friend? A friend in need is a friend indeed. No one can help us as Krishna can in times of need. He alone can because he needs nothing from us except devotion. He alone can because he is everywhere and eternal. Even good friends depart halfway through life. He goes on forever, even beyond life. He is all-powerful, hence none can be as helpful as he. He is all-caring and always caring, hence he is our best friend. You can count on him for help in all circumstances. Sugriva lost his wife and kingdom. He lost his social identity. The Lord Rama befriended him and gave him what he desired. Sudama's home was in shambles. His children and wife and he were poor to the core and hungry. The Lord, his royal friend, gave him so much that would last for generations. His friendship sees no limits. His love for us is boundless and pure. Vibhishana is cast out of the royal court of Lanka, abused by his nephew Indrajit as a traitor relative, as an ill-wisher, as an enemy hidden in one's own country. Unable to bear the multiple abuse and the harsh words of his demon brother Ravana, Vibhishana flies from Lanka to join Sri Rama with full faith. He is saved, honored, respected and crowned as the king of Lanka at the end of the battle. This is the fruit of true friendship. Uddhava is an old friend of Krishna who receives spiritual knowledge from him before the latter departs for Vaikuntha. He remains the historian of the Lord. Arjuna is a celebrated friend of Lord Krishna who turned into a non-paid chauffeur for 18 days to drive him on the battlefield. As a friend, he drove his chariot. As a mentor, he drove the chariot of his life through the immortal Bhagavad Gita, the sermon on the battlefield. Believe in Krishna, the eternal, unfailing friend. Tvameva mata cha pita tvameva, tvameva bandushcha sakha tvameva, tvameva vidya dravidam tvameva, tvameva sarvam mama deva deva. Thank you.